Hi everyone, the topic for today is ABN application. So in case like when you apply for an ABN number, in that application you will see you get three more options. More options, but these three are the basic options which everyone gets. The first is GST. It will ask you, do you want to register for GST, whether it's a company, individual or trust. They will always ask you, do you want to register for GST? Now, do you really want to register for GST? Okay, two things. If your turnover is likely to exceed more than 75,000, then you must register for GST. Number two, if your industry is in that category in which you compulsorily have to register for GST, such as taxi industry, if you want to drive Uber, then you have to compulsorily get registered. You don't have an option. In other cases, if you are not in that industry, or if your turnover is expected to be less than $75,000, then you don't have to be. Like it is, then it's an optional. You can get registered, you may not get registered. It is your option. Okay. So first thing is GST. Second thing is a trading name. It gives you option in case you want some trading name. For example, the name of your company is SSPTY LTD. So it will ask you, do you want to apply for a new trading name? Can be SS Foods or like any, you know, trading name. If you say yes, I want to apply, it will take you to the ASIC website, Australian Securities Investment Commission, where you apply for a trading name. It is not free of charge. I think you pay some amount for it. It has got option 1 year or 3 years, something like that. But it will give you an option to apply for a trading name. It is not mandatory. If you do not want to apply for a trading name, then you can work under your entity's name, which is, if your company name is SSPTY LTD, you can operate under SSPTY LTD. Or if your name is John Citizen, you can use your name, you know, John Citizen. You don't need a trading name to operate under your name. So it is not mandatory trading name, but if you want to apply, it is not free, but it will give you an option. The third thing is PAYG withholding. PAYG withholding means when you want to hire an employee, then you must register for PAYG withholding, which means that PAYG withholding means you can withhold the tax from their salary. So this is a mandatory requirement if you want to hire employees. If you want to hire employees, you must register for PAYG withholding, and in that option it will ask you how many expected employees. Just put an expected number and how much tax will you withhold from your employees. It is just an approximate number. It is, you know, it cannot be an exact number. So three things when you apply for ABN: GST, your trading name, and PAYG withholding. In case you have any question, just call us or register on our website, taxrefundonspot.com.au, and one of our accountants will give you a call same day. Thanks for watching. See you next time.